Happy morning to all. In the last class, we seen it a different kind of approaches to calculating the psi value based on our n minimum to maximum is equal to psi power n minus 1. So based on we get the psi value, we can evaluate it and we can took the in-between speed ratio from the our standard data books. Today we want to discuss about design a gearbox based on the ray diagram and the kinematic arrangements. Can we solve the one problem? You could understand why you drawn this like and how it will be converted as an our driven to driver mechanism in a gearbox aspects. Okay, just note on the problem. A gearbox is to be designed at 12 output speed from 160 to 2000 rpm full stop. The input speed of motor is 1600 rpm. Choosing a standard ratio and consider the speed diagram and the kinematic arrangements. So in our given problem, they directly mentioned the number of speeds. So given data, so number of speeds equal to 12 speeds and the n minimum case and the n maximum case, they are given in a problem 160 rpm to 2000 rpm respectively. To find speed ratio and the ray diagram and the kinematic arrangements. In a given problem, let's see, in a given problem, number of speed is provided, n minimum and n maximum also provided. They are asking speed reduction ratio and the ray diagram and kinematic arrangements. So already we know the things, how to calculation of psi value or speed reduction. N maximum divided by n minimum is equal to psi of n minus 1. Okay, so n maximum is equal to 2000, n minimum is equal to 160, is equal to psi power, number of speed is equal to 12, so 12 minus 1. So, but the ratio becomes 2000 divided by 160 is equal to 12.5 is equal to psi of 11. So, psi is equal to 12.5 the whole power 1 divided by 11. Finally, psi becomes 1.25. So, this is our psi value. Now, we want to refer the number of series like R5, R10, R20 and R40. So R5 value is equal to 1.6, R10 is equal to 1.25, R20 is equal to 1.12, R40 is equal to 1.06. Could you refer this value from 7.20 in our standard data book? Let's see. So this is R5 series, R10 series, this is R20 series, this is as an R40 series. Now you can compare with your psi value based on which series we can prefer. So our psi value is equal to 1.25. So based on R5 is not suitable for us, so R20 is probably suitable for us because both value can map it as a same value. So I can prefer the R10 series. Now I took the in-between speeds N2 to up to N11. N1, N2, N3, N4, N5, N6, N7, N8, N9, N10, N11, N12.
So our n minimum is equal to, you consider as an n1, 160 rpm, and n2, we choose the r10 series. So you took the r10 series. So 1.6 as a, you converted as a multiply with an 100. Next revolution you multiply with an 1000. While you considering the last value means you skip the first value. While you considering the first value in the sense, you can skip the last value. Okay, that is the procedure, because both values will be same. So 160, another one is 200, 250, 315, 400, 500, 630, 800, 1000, 1250, 1600, finally 2000. So now I don't want to skip any kind of speeds, because our cylinder is directly mapped with our RTM series. I can directly took the values next. There is no steps can be skipped. Understand? So this is called as type 1 method, direct method. Okay. So the incremental speed also can quantify the R10 series. Okay. So our first thing will be power. Now we want to consider the ray diagram with the help of the number of species. So already we preferred with the multiplication of preferred series, like 6 speed is a sense of 6 speed is equal to 2 of 1, 3 of 2. So it is multiplied with 2 in 1 into 2 is equal to 2, which should be come inside. So 3 into 2 is equal to 6. This is 6 speeds. As well as 9 speed means 3 of 1 is equal to 3 of 2. So it is multiplied with into this is equal to 9 speed. Now our problem is in 12 speeds. So we can prescribe the this kind of stage, like 3 of 1 is equal to 2 of 3 and 2 of 6. Can you compare 1 into 3, it multiplied with both here, and 2 of 3 is equal to multiplied with here. Finally our output is equal to 12 speeds. Understand? So this is stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. Based on our ray diagram can be constructed. So you consider as a 3 stage. Stage 1, stage 2 and stage 3. Totally 3 stages. Now you draw the 12 vertical lines up to bottom to topmost. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Now you consider as stage 1, this is stage 2, this is stage 3. Parallelly consider the vertical lines. This is called as shaft 1, shaft 2, shaft 3, this is shaft 4. Okay. Now you took the different 12 values plotted here, n1 to up to n12. So minimum speed to maximum speed. So our minimum speed is equal to 160 200, 250, 315, 400, 500, 630, 800, 1000, 1250, 1600, 2000. So parallelly you noted it here. Now you want to calculate the things which are from stage 1 to stage 2, stage 2 to stage 3, because maximum speed is from stage 1 to stage 2 and the maximum speed comes on the stage 2 to stage 3. This thing you should be evaluated with the help of two things which can be carried on n minimum divided by n input greater than or equal to 1 by 4, like n 0.25. Another case, n maximum divided by n input lesser or equal to 2. Both cases satisfied within a single point, then only you consider as a minimum and maximum speed. In a given problem, our lowest value is 160 is equal to, we consider as a minimum value. So it is marked as an A. Okay. Can you check it? The minimum cases 160. And here I want to make it the 6. 2 out of 6. 6 output I have got it. So you first skip it. Go to second point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is my maximum speed B. Carefully listen. 2 of 6. I have a 6 outputs. So 1 input is I got it. And another one is I calculated with the help of this sequences. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I am considering my minimum speed, my maximum speed. So I want to choose any input between those points, either 160 to 630. In between, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values. Among the 5 values, I can prefer to have one single value, which terminate this formula. Okay, now we want to check it. N minimum is equal to 160. Now I am considering as 400 as my input. Okay, 400. What is the value? 160 divided by 400 is equal to 0.4. It is satisfied with our input value of like 400. Now you could not change the input value, instead of you change the maximum value. Next case I choose the maximum case is 630 divided by 400. 630 divided by 400, I got 1.57. It is also satisfied. So now I am considered as an input speed is equal to 400. So you point as an C. Any doubt in this regard? Minimum and maximum, how can I prefer the input value? Based on the formula, I can verify with those things and I can mark it. Now I want to connect the lines. So this is my maximum. This is my minimum. Now I have 6 output. So I got 1. So remaining I can plot a nearby. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So parallel name it is C, D, E, F, G, H. Now we want to do the same things in the sense of dotted lines. So this line parallel with the other line. So Parallel, this line is parallel to another thing. Now you can verify, among the 12 lines, 6 into 2 can map to the all lines. So, in the case, particular cases, minimum, maximum, minimum, maximum. So, they are ranging between the two things. Okay, any doubt in this regards? Now we go with the, come with the second stage. How you choose the minimum value of 160? Now you forget all those things, only you consider these things. Okay, this is our least point in our stage 2. So now you consider as n minimum this value and n maximum is equal to directly to this, not. Here is 3 things. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. So this is your maximum. Understand? This is your maximum. This is your minimum. Among these lines, you can choose the input speed. Parallel, you can done with here. So here is now you can check it. N minimum value I can preferred by the last point 400. And the N input I can preferred with these two lines. So probably I can choose the next point 630. Is a greater one, so condition satisfied. Now I took it as my maximum is equal to 800. So n input same 630. 800 divided by 630 is equal to 1.27. So second condition also satisfied. So I am considering my input as a 630. Okay. So it is marked as an GHI. Now I want to join the two lines. So it is my minimum speed and it is my maximum speed. Now I have a 3 outputs. So I got 1. So remaining 2, 1, so 2, 3. I, J, K. So parallel stage 1 to stage 2, you can make the same dotted lines to join remaining things. Parallel this and parallel this. Now you can compare 6 into 2 is equal to 12 speed you can attain. Now 2 into 3 is equal to 6 speed. 1, 2, 3, 3 of 2 is equal to 6 speeds can attain. Now you compare with the last stage, I mean stage 1. Now you consider this point as your minimum. Okay. You forget those things. Stage 2, stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, you forget. You focus on stage 1. So it is the lowest value you consider as an this value is a minimum. So maximum it can be taken as an 1. So you consider all the things. Top to bottoms. Okay. So your n minimum is equal to these things. I will be considered as an input like 1600. Whether like we can check it, the point should be right or not. So now I am taking my minimum value is equal to 630. I choose the input is equal to 1600. 630 divided by 1600 is equal to 0.39. It is the greater, so condition satisfied. Now my maximum is equal to 1250. 1250 divided by 1600. Point 0.78. This condition also satisfied. So I got my input value is equal to here 1600 is tolerant this above formula, so it can be also satisfied. So I can make it as this line. So finally I can join three inputs. So one here, two here, and three here. Now you can check it. One screen, so three input contain the one output. So three lines with an one term. Any doubts in this regarding? This is called as an ray diagram, or sometimes as a structural diagram. Any doubt in this regarding? Once again, I will repeat. So first you draw the sequence in the respective manner. So you take the combination of 12 screens you can prefer, and the market as a minimum value to maximum value we are taking from the data books. So this value is directly mentioned here. So it is the lowest value you consider as an equilibrium minimum. So it is taken as a point A. Point B, why I am choosing this means, so total out speed is equal to 6. So I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is my minimum and maximum case. That's why market has named it as a B. So I have a minimum and a maximum speed. So in between I have an input. So from stage 2. So that will be satisfied with the formula. I can prefer 400 as my input. Parallelly I do with the stage 2, stage 1. Okay, would you understand? Now we go with the kinematic arrangements. Okay, so we also completing the second thing also, ray diagram. How we can construct based on the series of preferred things. Now you ray diagram you drawn by vertical, it will be converted as an horizontal things. Okay, that is the kinematic arrangement. So you draw and ray diagram you construct it like here vertically. Now you click it as a horizontal things. So totally 1, 2, 3, 4 lines. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so in between you mentioned here stage 1, stage 2, whatever this stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. Understand? So parallel you mentioned here shaft 1, shaft 2, shaft 3, shaft 4. Now you look the diagrams. For example, 1, 2, 3. Among the 3, you can mention the previous cases how many come? 3, 2, another 2. This is your way now. So you have 3 gear pair. So you draw it directly here. So based on this 3 gear, you want to, you consider this is as a driver means you need a dribble. Okay, so small speed to high speed. So you connected any one among the 3 pairs, remaining is to be an ideal. Understand? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so you consider that this is driver means this is driven. This is driven in the sense of this is driver. Okay, both those cases you can couple with the help of 3 pair gear. Okay, among the 3, you can transfer in any one to another stage. So I am choosing this middle speed. It will be transferred from shaft 1 to shaft 2. So shaft 2 I have only 2 gear pair. So I draw only 2 gear. Among the 2 gears I can couple with any one. So I can couple with 1. Remaining should be in the ideal cases. Now you consider this is 6, this this is 7, this is 8, this is 9, this is 10. Okay, last one, I transfer in the 1 speed. So, 2 gear, remaining also 2 gear. Coupled with the 1, remaining should be IDI. So it will be 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So you consider 12 speed gearbox needed to operate in the 14 kind of gear pair. So Z1 to Z14 teeth. Okay, now you check it. Among the 3 pair, you transfer the input to shaft 1 to shaft 2. So it will be chosen. So it will be transferred to shaft 2. Shaft 2 also transferring the 1 speed to shaft 3. You consider this is transferred to shaft 3. Now you compare with this. This is called as kinematic arrangement or in a structural arrangements. Any doubt in this regards how to draw this diagram? So then it had asked me the number of teeth is. So you consider as a N1, N2. You consider N1, N2, N3, N4, N5, N6. These are the number of speeds. Which are the things we can mark with the ray diagram. Okay.